Hello everyone. Today we're talking about affirmations. Do they work and how to use them? So I personally have been using affirmations for years and years and years, and they have completely changed my life. As you know, I often prescribe certain affirmations in a lot of my programs. What I've learned is that affirmations are like anything else in life. If you're willing to do them consistently, they will work. Most diets work, most fitness plans work, but only for the people that consistently stick it out. So I think with affirmations, people ditch them too quickly. I often get questions like, well, I feel like a fake or I feel like a liar when I'm saying the affirmations. And my response is good, because your affirmations are supposed to take you to the next level you. To this old self, to this old personality, of course it's going to seem like a lie. That's the whole point. We're trying to get rid of the old belief systems and reprogram your subconscious for the new belief system, the new affirmation. So if it feels like a lie in the beginning, good, you're on the right track. If it doesn't, then you probably need another affirmation, because that's probably already a part of your subconscious programming. So why do we use affirmations? We have a certain set of belief systems that we have acquired probably unconsciously in our childhood. When we're from ages 0 to 7, our brain is kind of in a state of natural hypnosis. We pick up everything from our environment, what our parents say, what they believe, their actions, how everyone relates to us, that gets programmed, good or bad, in our subconscious. So most people as adults are still functioning from that child programming. And this is why affirmations are great. You can use them as a way to reprogram your subconscious. So you see, hypnosis is a way to reprogram the subconscious, but another way more powerful way to reprogram the subconscious is by the use of habits and repetition. So whatever you repeatedly do, your subconscious memorizes, because it says this must be important because this person keeps doing it over and over again or saying it over and over again. So that becomes your new programming. And that's why affirmations are great. They easily change your subconscious programming if you're willing to do them again and again repeatedly. So what's the correct way to use an affirmation? So if you know that you have a limiting belief in a certain area or you're stuck, what's the next level you? What would that version of you believe? And so you would adapt that new affirmation, and I'll give you my 5 most life-changing affirmations. I've got a ton, but I'm gonna share my 5 most. So you would take that affirmation and you would repeat it every single day, thousands of times. People ask me, should I say it 3 times? I'm like, no, say it until people think you're crazy and you need to be committed. Like, that's how many times I say affirmations throughout the day. Millions of times, where your subconscious goes, okay, I get it, stop already, right? You just say it like you're a psycho. That's when it starts kind of developing as your new self. Another thing I want to add is that say it with some feeling, right? So anything that you have a strong emotional reaction to, that gets registered, because it must be really important because you had a strong reaction to it. So if you have a really strong reaction every time someone says something negative, and then you try to say an affirmation and you totally are like, yes, I'm so worthy. You had a strong reaction to that thing and not so strong of a reaction to the affirmation. So put some feeling into it. Put some life into it, right? So when you're saying, I'm so powerful, feel into it. Yeah, I am so powerful. Better yet, think of some times in the past where you felt powerful. When you learned how to tie your shoelaces, when you rode your bike for the first time, when you got that first job, didn't you feel powerful? Tap into that feeling, because that's going to remind you of and give you instances of, yeah, I am powerful, right? So let's talk about, well, let's recap and then I'll give you my 5 best. 1, they work. Do them consistently. 2, feel into them. Yeah, feel into them. Yeah, this is the new me. 3, repeat, 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 Repeat until everyone, including yourself, thinks you're nuts.
Okay, so are you ready to hear my 5 most life-changing mantras/affirmations?
By the way, I use those words interchangeably. Some people don't. That's okay. Number one, I am enough. Say it all the time. I am enough. I am enough. I am enough. Put it on your mirror. Put it in a notebook. Get it tattooed. No, maybe not tattooed. But maybe fake tattoo or something. Put it everywhere. I have my daughter say this all the time. We repeat it together when we're getting dressed in the morning. Say it all the time, and then you'll realize there will come a time where you just believe it. You don't even have to say it. And whatever unworthy issue you've got going on underneath, this will get replaced by that. So what you'll notice with an affirmation is that in the beginning when you say it, it's gonna feel like, you know, like a lie, as people say. But again, that's the old self would believe that as a lie. The new next version of you would consider that a fact. To her, that would be the truth. So in the beginning, it's gonna feel like that. Then you'll notice that if you say it enough consistently, that your behaviors will all of a sudden start changing to match that affirmation. That's when you know that you're on the right track. Because what happens, for example, the I am enough, let's say you're saying that for a week, like millions of times. The second week, if something happened and you get triggered, there's gonna be a part of you that's gonna say, well, why am I triggered by that? I am enough. And then you're gonna be like, yeah, I'm enough. And then you'll keep saying it, and you'll become more self-aware, and that thing will no longer trigger you because you are enough. Number two, I am safe. This is a big one. I have my Sacred Feminine Intensive students say this all the time. Our brains, especially the female brain, has inherited naturally a lot of fear consciousness. It's just there. Even if you somehow escaped it, it's in your DNA. So it's there. It just seems like there's fear lurking in every situation, in every man, in every job, in every new opportunity. And so if you just start saying, I'm safe, I'm safe, I'm safe. Again, say it like a psycho, say it like a psycho. I am safe. Say it when you're feeling safe, especially say it when you're not feeling safe. Let that become your go-to. Stay tuned till the end, because I just thought of one more thing I want to add to this. One common mistake that everyone makes with affirmations. Remind me at the end. Number three, I am love. This is a powerful one, because we get so trapped in seeking love and wanting love and love languages and love me just this way, or I'm not going to be happy because this is my goddamn love language. Love me this way. But if you're like, I am love, then you're open to being love and receiving love in all its different varieties and flavors. And no one has to love you hanging upside down for you to feel love. You just are love. And a funny thing happens when you repeat this enough times. You start noticing that there is love all around you, that everyone around you is trying to love you in their own unique way and flavor. Even if they suck at it, they're trying to love you. And you just step into it. So that's one of my most life-changing ones. Four, ooh, this is a good one. My worth is never in question. He didn't propose. My worth is never in question. So it must be about him. There must be something else going on. He doesn't want to have sex with me. My worthiness is never in question. She didn't invite me to that party. My worthiness is never in question. Those jeans don't fit. My worthiness is never in question. If you say this enough, you realize that you've been taking things personally. It's never about you. It's never about your worth. Whatever someone's got going on is none of your business, because your worthiness is never in question, right? It's never about you. If you weren't meant to go to that party, if you weren't meant to be with that man or be in that relationship or have the baby or be that size, then that's it. It's nothing personal. It's not about your worth. Your worthiness stays consistently high. You are worthy. You are enough. You are love. Number five, money comes easily and frequently. I know this is an odd one in the rest of the mix, but this is one of my most life-changing. We have a lot of fear consciousness sometimes around money, and will it stay consistently in our lives? The way that I was brought up and the way that I developed my
my money consciousness was that money is easy to make, but it's easy to lose. And so I really had to work hard to shed that, because I would make globs of money and then lose it, and then make a lot of money and then lose it. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to step outside of this. And I started saying, money comes easily and frequently. Money comes easily and frequently. Then I stepped it up and I said, and it stays. Money comes easily and frequently, and it stays. It stays around. It loves me. It's magnetized towards me. So adapt these, make up your own depending on what your needs are, what your limiting beliefs are, and repeat them until you're psychotic and people want to have you committed. What's that one mistake that I hear people making all the time? They try to change too many things at the same time. So the way that your subconscious works is you have to repeat something enough times so it becomes your programming. But if you're trying to say 50,000 different new mantras, it's too much confusion. It's not enough emotional investment. It's not enough repetition in one thing to make that your go-to new programming. So choose one little area of your life and freaking attack it. Say that affirmation, right? Like your life depends on it. And then make that your go-to. And now I know what I'm going to hear. I get this in a lot of my programs. Well, but what if I can't choose one area? Choose one area. Choose one area. Choose it. Just do it. Choose one area. Do it, and then you'll get a chance to choose another area. I promise. It doesn't take that long. How long does it take? I don't know. It depends on how tattooed, ingrained is that other programming. For some belief systems, it took me 2 weeks of being a crazy psychopath and repeating something. In other areas, it took me 2 years because that thing was really tattooed in. So be invested, be all in, repeat it until you're crazy, and you will see results. I'll see you in the next one.